question just between you and me. A bullet to that guy in the chest. Satisfactory?
Sounds good.
All right.
Through secret audio and video recordings, the Associated Press got a rare look inside a foiled murder plot of a black inmate by prison guards. The guards were Ku Klux Klansmen, who operated inside a Florida prison undetected until federal investigators got involved.
It's surprising that we're even having a conversation about something that was prevalent in the 1920s, taking place 100 years later.
The modern-day Klan murder plot begins inside the prison hospital called the Reception and Medical Center. Inmate Warren Williams gets into a fight with prison guard Thomas Driver.
Driver was smoking at the time, and he was blowing cigarette smoke in his face, and he asked him to stop, and he wouldn't stop.
Williams ends up biting Driver. Weeks later, the guard, still enraged, complains to another Klansman about potentially being exposed to a disease.
You know, that blood work that I had to go through, you know, the mental stress of it, you know, worrying that I'm going to have to catch this from this dirty-ass monkey, all because, you know, he can't beat me like a man.
Driver wants revenge and recruits two other Klansmen. One, a sergeant at the prison, and the other, a former guard and local Klan leader known as the Exalted Cyclops. They decide to kill Williams after his release from prison in a few months. They turn to the KKK's hitman known as the Grand Nighthawk.
So, are we just gonna snatch him up right there and take him to the river, or how are we gonna work this?
I'm gonna let you decide how you wanna do it.
Do you have you already have a weapon for this?
I think the situation will dictate that when we get on the ground and look around.
On January 30th, 2015, three Klansmen take a drive to Williams' home in Palatka, Florida to scope out the area. They also discuss killing Williams on the spot with an injection if they see him.
Sarge, I brought some insulin. Me and Brother Joe was talking. Just kind of grab his ass up.
When are we going to grab him now?
The men are discouraged by several patrol cars in the area. They regroup at one of the Klansmen's homes.
Well, I got you here.
Mm-hmm. This is a question just between you and me. A bullet to that guy in the chest. Satisfactory?
Sounds good.
All right.
2 months later, the Klan hitman comes back with photographic proof of Williams' death. The Klansmen rejoice over the photos showing Williams lying on the ground with apparent gunshot wounds.
All right.
Oh. I love it. He's going in trouble. Good job.
That works.
Is that what you wanted?
Oh, yes.
Are you happy with that, brother?
Yes, sir. Very much so.
Okay.
Thank you, brother.
What the guards didn't know at the time was that they were being secretly recorded by the FBI. The Grand Nighthawk was actually an FBI informant. Agents had staged the murder scene with Williams.
Hands down, across for law enforcement, a confidential informant or an undercover officer or agent are the most effective ways to infiltrate an organization.
Driver pleaded guilty to conspiracy to commit murder and was sentenced to 4 years. His two accomplices are also serving time. None of them would speak to the AP. Despite this case, Florida's Department of Corrections said it found no reason to investigate more broadly whether other white supremacists were employed in its prisons.
I think the most effective thing we can do right now, as we've seen these groups come and emerge and evolve, is an education for our law enforcement agencies across the country. Is here's what this extremism, here's what white supremacy is today.
Williams also declined an interview request. His mother says they live with uncertainty and fear.
It's not good for him. It's not. You know, sometimes he's in that self-protection mode, and it's like everybody trying to get him.
As for the FBI informant, he was placed in protective custody with his whereabouts unknown.